This is Pastor Atwell and Bishop Vincent.
Let me
prayer,
give the worship.
Praise and worship.
Where's all of my praise? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God.
Welcome to the hour of prayer, praise, and worship. Coming to you from Cape.
Let the heavens rejoice, let the earth be glad, let the people of God sing his praise all over the land. Everyone in the valley, come and lift your voice. All those on the mountaintop, be glad and shout for joy.
Rise up and praise him. He deserves our love. Rise up and praise him.
A pleasant good morning to you in Radio Land. This is Pastor Atwell and Bishop Vincent. We just want to stop for a moment to speak to our Father this morning. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your peace and for your joy. We thank you for your love, your care, and your concern for us. Father, we thank you that you brought us, woke us up this morning, and you started us on our way. You have been good to us. You have been better to us than we have been to ourselves. And this morning, God, as we come to you, we ask, God, that you will touch each of us from the very crown of our head to the sole of our feet. You will touch everyone that is in Radio Land listening this morning. God, you will anoint the ears of your people to hear your praises and to hear your word this morning, O God. Those of you that are getting ready to go to church this morning, we pray that God will quicken you, he will strengthen you, he will lift you up, and he will take you off of your bed and take you into his house to give him the praise, the honor, and the glory. Father, we thank you. We thank you for that banner over us, which is love. God, we thank you for this radio station, this opportunity to come to your people. We ask you this morning, God, for your anointing, for your power to fall in this studio. Oh God, touch Bishop Vincent in a special way, the man of God who you have called into your kingdom for this time. Father, we pray, oh God, that you would minister. Let your will be done in us this morning, oh God, and let your glory be revealed as we go before you to bring your praises and to bring your word. God bless everyone this morning. Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. And we thank you.
Rise up and praise him.
Lord, we lift our praise to you.
Don't worry about praise.
Rise up.
Praise the Lord. This is Faith Life Ministries, coming to you this morning from 844 Clarkson Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, between East 51st and Utica Avenue, where we would bring to you a life-changing experience. You will never be the same again. You would feel the difference at Faith Life Ministries. Join us for our divine worship at 11:30 a.m. this morning. You don't have a place to worship, come join us. We are also, on Friday night, we have our deliverance services, which start at 7:30 p.m. And Wednesday night is our Bible study. Join us if you have time, or if you need prayer, you can call us at 718-735-9687. Faith Life Ministries, where the man of God who is in charge is Bishop Dennis Vinson.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. Shine.
See you.
For those of you who have just tuned in, it's now 11 minutes on the other side of 6 o'clock. This is the welcome to the hour of prayer, praise, and worship, coming to you from Faith Life Ministries at 844 Clarkson Avenue, Brooklyn, New York. Life-changing experience you will get at Faith Life Ministry. You will never be the same because God is in the house. You would feel the difference at Faith Life Ministry because our purpose is to restore your faith and speak life into you. It's a great morning. It's a great Sunday morning. Another Sunday morning in the presence of the Lord, where we are now getting ready to bring you the praises and bring you the glory of God into your household this morning. We thank God for the presence of the bishop this morning with me. It's Bishop Vincent. He's here this morning, and you're going to hear from him in just a moment. Stay tuned this morning as we bring you the glory and the praise and the honor of our God, who is worthy to be praised and who is worthy to be lifted up. This is Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. You can call us this morning at 347-663-8638. Or you can call in this morning at 718-735-9687. We are here to help you this morning. We are here to bless your heart this morning. If you need prayer, you need counseling, you need to talk to the bishop this morning, We are here. To help you this morning. Any problem that you might be facing, you just got up and you don't feel too well, and you are deciding whether if you want to go to the house of the Lord or not, and you need some encouragement, you need some inspiration, call us. Call us at Choice Radio, 347-663-8637. Or if you need prayer this morning, you need someone to pray for you, there's someone standing by at 718-735-9687. Thank you. Right at this time, I just want to bring on Bishop Vincent, and he's going to let God have his way this morning, and he's going to introduce himself, and he's going to talk to you this morning. Right at this time, I want you to hear the voice of Bishop Dennis Vincent.
God bless you in Radio Land. We greet each and everyone this morning. You are listening to the Hour of Prayer studio, where God means a lot to the nation. So we praise the name of the Lord for you. My name is Bishop Vincent, coming from Faith Life Ministry. That's 844 Clarkson Avenue. And we want to invite you to the service this morning. God will be there, ready to bless, ready to touch your lives, whatever condition. We are looking forward. We have a guest speaker in church this morning. His name is Pastor Koraya from the island of Trinidad, man of God, anointed, well known by the public, and we are looking forward for a grand time. It's amazing what the Lord is doing in our days as we continue to lift him up, looking at what is happening in our nation, what is taking place in the island, the surrounding, and we are looking forward that you can make a difference in your life. You can make a difference. You can take a step of faith, and you can trust in the Lord. And all you have to say with the situation and the happenings, I need to serve the Lord. I need to make a declaration, and this I will do. This December month, I will spend my time praising God, lifting up the name of Christ, because he is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. So as we continue to go on the path of righteousness, listen, this December month, Reverend Vincent is telling you, time to live for the Lord is now. Why don't you come on? Open up your heart. You need prayer. You need God is doing something in your life. You're frustrated over circumstances, situation faces you. Whatever your problem, you might be sitting down sick and can't recover. Do not understand what's happening. Immigration problem, home problem, family problem. You got a friend. His name is Jesus. And Reverend Vincent and Faith Life family is here to help you. Why don't you take up that phone right now? Call us. God will bless you. Call the studio, 347-663-8638. You can call that number, 718-735-9687. There's going to be someone awaiting to take your request to pray. God bless you. We are looking forward, amen, in talking with you in a morning service. 1130 Faith Life Ministry, 844 Clarkson Avenue, between East 51st and Utica. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you as we continue to press on the upward way. In Jesus' name.
God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to his side.
By a roadway in the wilderness,
I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. You need help this morning, call upon the name of the Lord. He is our God. He is a present help in the time of trouble. He is your refuge. You can call upon him this morning. Whatever you may be going through this morning, whatever your problem, whatever your situation, God is standing by. Jesus is at the right hand of God the Father. He's making intercession for you. He's waiting to hear your heart's cry. Call upon the name of the Lord this morning. Call us this morning. We can counsel you. We can talk to you. We can bless you this morning by the anointing and the power that God has placed within us to pray for you and to let you know thus what said the Lord.
You are our God.
Right at this time, I want to ask Bishop Vincent to really talk to the people in Radio Land this morning. A lot of us are getting ready to go into the house of the Lord. And you know, sometimes when we are in church and we go to the house of the Lord and we are really waiting for the song leaders and the worship leaders to pump us up and to encourage us to praise God. But when I think about the Word of God, which says to enter into His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise, that tells me that I am supposed to leave my house. When I leave to go to the house of the Lord, I am supposed to leave ready. I'm supposed to leave prepared. I'm supposed to walk with a praise. I'm not supposed to wait for a praise to come to me. Bishop Vincent, encourage the people this morning.
Well, it's so important in church. When we leave our houses, when we leave home, we decide that we are going to the house of God. Some people has a reality fact that they go to church, and when they reach into the temple, whether the service start or not, that person will sit down, they will go to the altar, they will take a corner, they will open the Bible, they will pray, and while they're praying, they're talking to God. This means a lot, where some people just get into the service and they wait to be pushed. And this is not the reality of going out for fellowship. The church is lacking so many ways, but we are the children of God. We are the people of God, and we can just make a difference. When we get into the house of God, at some time, the best service you can have is when you go in spontaneously and begin to worship God. Look to God for the things that are happening. When the song service is through and the preacher comes, and that man or that woman of God, whoever they are, they have an opportunity to face the congregation, because God is already anointing them and upon the life, and everyone will benefit. We talk about something all the time. You will hear me speaking about it, the benefits of the cross. And when we get into the house of God, we are looking for benefits. What type of benefits? We are looking for the blessings of the Lord, but we have to put out. What are we going to put out? The Bible said, to whom much is given, much is required. So I want to encourage you this Sunday morning, get into your church, get into your chapel, in that congregation, get into that house where you are assigned to do praises unto Him, because we are coming to you, and the name of this program, Glory to God, is the hour of prayer. And we have a condition here. We got to praise Him. We got to talk to Him. We got to magnify His name, because He is the one that is blessing us. He is the one that is supplying our needs according to His riches and glory. So my advice to you, get yourself together. Amen. This morning, if you don't have a place of worship, you don't know where to turn to, we want to invite you to 844 Clarkson Avenue. And this is Faith Life Ministry. We got a special speaker. Pastor Hezekiah, Pastor Koriah. Koriah will be with us this morning, lifting up the name of Jesus, a man of God, known to the public for His word. Amen. He hears from God. He ministers. He feels the love, and he supplied the word that comes to him, because God is on his side. So we want to invite you. You don't have a place to worship? We will welcome you, because at Faith Life, God is there ready to encourage the life of the people. So let us continue in Jesus' name as we look forward. Amen. Amen.
You know, Bishop, when I look at the psalmist David, and the Bible says he was a praiser, and I look at one of his verses, said, "It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto His name." And what David is saying to us this morning, that We have no choice.
We have no choice.
We just got to do what God has called
Amen.
Us to do, to bless his name. The Bible says when we praise God and we lift up our praises unto God, the blessings come down.
You see, David acknowledged the fact that he received from God. You know what it is, Pastor Atwell, to receive from God. And this is where David found himself. He received from God. If we, the children of God, will get into the church and open up our hearts, God will bless us. Then we have no other alternative more than to praise him. How much do we praise the name of the Lord today? We don't put out. We don't put much. We don't do much. We go and we sit down. It's just like we go into the supermarket. We're looking for an item. We're looking for something to buy, to pay for our money. But it's different when we get in that house of God. If we put out, and that's David's experience. David failed God, but David received from the hands of God. And this is what we need to do, to open up our hearts to receive from the Lord.
And the other thing, Bishop, I found out and I realized that a lot of people do mouth praise. But I found out that praise is not from the mouth. Praise have to come from the heart. Because when you think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for you, your heart supposed to explode and give God the praise.
If you look at anyone that is singing praises unto God, that person do not just do lip service, but out of the innermost being, when they put out, you can feel the expression of what that person is doing. What is happening? We are not doing lip service. We are not making action, but we are putting out from our innermost being. And when we put out from our innermost being, God blesses us, because God is looking at our effort. He's looking at our contribution. What do you have to contribute to the Lord? Are you just going and say, Lord, well, let your will be done? Yes, we want the will of God to take place in our life. But listen, ladies and gentlemen, listen, brethren, listen, people, whoever you are, we got to put out. Stop doing lip service. Oh my God, let's get into the house of God and praise him. Open up your mouth, open up your heart, open up your mind and praise him. He is looking for that. He wants you to do that, and you're going to be blessed all the time in the house of God.
That is why I love the psalmist. Psalmist David says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. He says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. So what David is saying is, it's not just my mouth, it's all my hands, my feet, my body, my head, my brain, my everything. I'm going to give it, I'm going to use it, and I'm going to bless the Lord.
I'm going to take my all, I'm going to give my all. Have you acknowledged, we were in service in prayer meeting Friday night into Saturday morning. And as we put forth, amen, we felt that the presence of God, what's happening is that we put out. If nothing from nothing leaves nothing,
amen.
You can't expect to put nothing in and receive anything. You cannot just sit in the church, spectate, look around, gaze around like nothing happened. Come on, you don't expect to receive from God. But when you go into the house of God, amen, you remember David said, I will enter into its courts. And when David entered in, he realized that I was putting my all, and then God will bless. In the church, wherever you are today, in the home, when you put out, God will bless you. God will take concern. God will take control and bless you real good. Sing a new song of praise unto the Lord.
Praise the Lord. It's now 37 minutes on the other side of 6 o'clock. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Choice Radio. Here we go. Here we go. Yeah. 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 Want inspiration. Want to be lifted and refreshed. You got to turn. Turn your radio.
Choice Radio. Choice Radio.
This music brings healing. Brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on listening.
Choice Radio.
You have just tuned in. You are listening to Faith Life Ministries, where you can have a life-changing experience. You will never be the same again because God is in the house. You can be delivered. You can be set free. Our purpose is to bring you life and to make sure that God is able to help you this morning to change your life and be the person that God wants you to be. Be blessed this morning in the name of Jesus. That's the kind of God we serve. He's a God of salvation. He's a God of peace. He's a God of love. He's a God that cares about you and your situation. Whatever you may be going through this morning, God is waiting to hear from you. He's waiting to hear your heart's cry. Cry out to him this morning because he is God and there is no other.
Yeah.
Right now, I'm just feeling in my spirit that there's someone out there. You are feeling burdened down. You are feeling persecuted. You are feeling that the world is against you and everybody's coming up against you, and you want to know why all this is happening to you, and you feel burdened down. You said, why is this happening to me right at this time? Like if the whole world is against you, and you want to know what to do, you want to know why is this happening. You are questioning yourself, what did I do wrong? What did I do that caused this to be on me? Why everybody is against me? I just want to ask our bishop right at this time to pray for you, because I just feel it in my spirit that I should say this on the radio, because it's in my spirit right now that you are there, you are out there, and this is how you are feeling. You got up this morning and you are saying, why Lord, why Lord? Bishop, pray.
God means good for you, whatever the position is right now. We want you to, if you're listening to a radio that is by your side, and whatever you're sitting down, rest your hand in the radio as a point of contact. Because listen, just as we picked it up, just as the man of God picked it up in the studio, wherever you are, God can reach you, because there is no distance in prayer, and God wants to bless you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we present this person to you, whoever they are. It could be a man, it could be a woman, it could be a boy, it could be a girl. But oh God, we are asking right now that you stretch your hands from above and touch that individual. We pray, God, that the sickness, the contact, the pressure, the burden that person is feeling right now, we rebuke it in the name of Jesus, and we claim the authority through the blood. It's done. The job is done. You just have to have faith. Call us right now and let us know what's happening. Your testimony could be heard on the air, because I know God has done something right now in your life.
347-663-8638. That's the studio. Or call at 718-735-9687. Someone is standing by to pray with you. The psalmist David says, fret not thyself because of evildoers. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. Listen, this morning, and that person may have been listening to the radio, and I know you are out there. Trust in the Lord, because he is able to bring you through.
Amen.
About Daniel in the lion's den, it didn't look too good, but Daniel put his trust in him.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego,
when the flames grew hot,
they
just put their trust in God, and he would not let them go. Oh yes, God is able.
God is able.
My God is able. Yes, he's able.
God is able.
He can do what he said he would do.
My God is able.
God is able. Yes, he is.
God is able.
God is able.
God is able.
He can do what he said he'd
do.
I think about Israel and the Exodus. Pharaoh sent his men, but God showed his faithfulness. So if you think you're in a trial by fire, when the flames grow hot,
they grow hot,
you just put your trust in God, and he'll never let you go. I know God is able.
God is able.
My God is able.
God is able.
He's able.
God is able.
He can do what he said he would do.
My God is able.
God
You ought to try him.
God is able.
Because he's able.
God is able.
He can do what he said he
can. Our purpose here this morning is to speak life to you and to restore your faith. It is important that your faith is restored, because we serve a God who is able.
He'll be there for you. Will you believe him? Will you receive
him. God is able. Because
he can do what he said.
God is able. He's able
to do what he said.
God is able.
He can do what he said. Can do.
God is able.
Yeah, I see him.
God is able.
He's gonna do.
Bishop, you know, ministry, faith life ministry. You know, when I think about the situation that people are going through today, and people are losing faith, people are falling on the wayside. They are just discouraged, and they don't know what to do. And, you know, when you have a ministry that is named Faith Life, and, you know, I keep telling the people our purpose here is to restore faith and speak life into people. This morning, I just want you to encourage the people on what is going on when their faith is failing and they just don't know what to do.
If you're out there and your faith is failing, it means that you have a problem and you need help. We are here to help you. We are here to encourage you. We advertise this and we tell people we have free counseling. You can get in touch with us at church. Amen. You can call that number, 718-773-7515. Another number, 718-735-9687. And also we give you a cell number that you can call. That number is 347-444-6986. As Pastor Atwell just rightly said, that people's faith are dropping. They're losing now. They're getting frustrated over situations. They're on the job, in the churches, in their homes. They are getting fed up and discouraged. But we are telling you today that we have an opportunity open. Because why? We wait upon the Lord. We talk to God. We spend time. Amen. We do not waste our time in our 5 o'clock prayer meeting every Saturday. We talk to God about people. We saw people coming in all the way from Queens. People are making their way out to a 5 o'clock prayer meeting. And God is meeting the condition. God going to bless you. So right now, if you have a problem, you have a need, you can call. We have able minister who will just talk to you and encourage you. Amen. And when you do that, we know it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit of God. God will bless you. And our Faith Life ministry, it's a place, this church was definitely, amen, established on faith. If you hear the story of the establishment of Faith Life Ministry, you will know that God has a people with a burden and a concern. We are concerned about people. That's why when we look, we do not just preach the word to people, but we look into the word of God and we are thinking about the whole man. We even supply and distribute food to people. So if you have a problem, you can meet us. God will bless you.
And I want to plug something here, and I want to encourage you out there in Radio Land. We are not asking you to leave your church. This is not what Faith Life is about. Because a lot of people may hear us, you know, encouraging you to come to church. And this is for those people who don't have a church home. This is for those people who want to come to a church and be restored. So if you are in your church and you are comfortable there, this is not for you.
Amen.
This is not for you. And I want to make this straight this morning. It is not for you. Stay where you are. Because if God is blessing you there, we don't need you to come and cause any problem for us.
Amen.
So stay at your church and worship God. But if there, for some reason, you are not comfortable and you want us to just encourage you, because we are able to just encourage you and send you right back to where you came from. This is not what it's about. This is not about stealing church members. And I want to make this clear this morning. We are here to encourage you. We are here to build your faith. We are here to speak life into your being, because we serve a big God. We serve a big and mighty God. It is all about love. It's all about care. It's all about the concern for the whole man.
Amen.
I want you to stay tuned. We will be right back.
Choice Radio. Your life. Your salvation. Your choice. Choice Radio.
God will give you an unbelievable love. And I just want to encourage you this morning that His love is now surrounding you. All you got to do is to put your hands up and accept that love that God wants to give to you.
Feel the sun on my face. I'm overwhelmed by the reality.
You know, it's amazing, Pastor Vincent, and you know, when I think about the sacrifice that God made for me, I ask the question, is there anybody else out there who is willing to make that sacrifice for me? Is there anyone else out there who is willing to give up their life for me? You know, God is such a great God that He made the ultimate sacrifice, and I mean the altar. There is no other sacrifice that was made by anybody else that can save me. When I think about the individual at well, the person that God had put His hand on, the personality of the man, the attitude of the man, the spirit of the man, and yet still God saw it fit to touch my life. Pastor Vincent, talk to the people. There is
no other person, no other way we can find that any individual will make that sacrifice. Even us as ministers, they not try to die to to go to the cross for any one of our relatives, any one of our children, as loving as they are. We are not commissioned to do such because Jesus Christ, the Son of God, he took upon himself all the curse, all the pain, all the iniquity that framed the wrong anyone, even you, Pastor. God paid for that. He died that you may have life and have it more abundantly. That's why I tell people, I'm not in the recycling business of recycling souls, people that will just come and go, come and go. We are here to win the loss at any cost, because we were on the outside deep in sin. We were given over by so many people ready to die. They looked at some of us and feel, and maybe you are in that situation, they look to you and say, nothing good will come out of you. But today, because of a transformation and the blood of Jesus that is able to save, amen, you can look to the world and say, look at what God made out of me. He took me from nowhere. He took me from the gutter hole of sin, and he redeemed my life. And today, amen, I can tell the world, I can show the world, Jesus is all we need. So whoever you are, if you're outside in whatever condition you are in right now, you are failing your family, you're even failing yourself, and you're saying, oh, I'm good for nothing, I don't have any value. Stop. Think for a while. You are precious. You have value. You can come to Jesus Christ right now. You're given over to die, rejected by your friends, rejected by men. Take a look at your life. Accept Jesus. Make a turn. Call these numbers that we continue giving you. There is someone there awaiting right now. 718-735-9687. Someone will take your call, talk to you, and encourage you. And most of all, this Sunday morning, you have an opportunity. You can come and worship the Lord with us at Faith Life Ministry. Yes, Faith Life Ministry, a place of comfort, a place of help, a place of restoration. The church where God's people has a desire just to love anyone that come in their path. We are looking for you at the door. Regardless to your situation, take a step of faith and let God bless you this morning as you come out and worship with us in the name of the Lord.
And that's all because of the God that we serve, who shares an unbelievable love. I'll play this song for you one more time. Listen to this song as God bless you.
On my face, and I'm overwhelmed just yesterday I was afraid that I would never be free. But his loving arms reached out and brought me so near. Oh, breaking the chains of all my doubts and my fears. Well, unbelievable, unbelievable love. So hard to understand, inconceivable, that the Lord of it all can take me just as I am. He knew the price that he had to pay.
What a love. You know, sometimes, you know, people say to you, I love you. You know, even your wife may say to you, I love you. And as you make a mistake, they come at you like a lion. But we recognize today that God's love is such an unbelievable love, such a love that we cannot understand, that no matter what situation we are in, no matter where we are, He is able to pull us up and out of every situation. It's an unbelievable love. A love that I cannot comprehend. You cannot comprehend. No man could really comprehend this love, because the love of God is just special. He's so sweet. He is a savior. He's a loving God. You know, I thank God today for salvation. I thank God today because, listen, saints, you don't know where I could have been. You really don't know where I could have been. I could have been dead and gone. God, you know, I could have been cut off without remedy. And many of us are and was in that situation. But I just want you to remember this morning that unbelievable love of God.
Searching for a lifetime for some things to satisfy. Paid a lot of prices on so many nights I cried. In my time of desperation came a simple revelation, and that was all I ever really wanted was you. Thought I wanted money, and I thought I wanted fame.
Do you want him in your life this morning? Do you want God in your life this morning? He's calling upon you this morning. He's waiting on you. Just listen to this song this morning so that God can bless you. He can bless your heart this morning.
No one to think of you. But when I turned around, I turned and found you were there all the time. I didn't know where to go. I didn't know but you loved me till you loved me to the truth. Yes, you
loved me right here.
If there were a moral to the things that I have learned, yeah, it would be to follow love every move and every turn. In the time of second chances, what I found at second glances is that all I ever really wanted was you, yeah. There were times I didn't know what
I was to do,
But when I turned around, I turned and found you were there
all my time.
I didn't know what
or where to go.
Said I didn't know what
I was to know.
But then you loved me till you loved me to the truth. Yeah, you loved me back to you. Yeah, if there were a moral for the things that I have learned, oh, it would be to follow love, every move and every turn. For in time of second chances, while I found in second glances, is that all I ever really wanted? You know I found in you. Oh, all I ever really wanted. Somehow I know it's true. Oh my. Somehow I know it's true.
Somehow,
oh, 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 oh.
Was
you, oh Lord.
Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Faith Life Ministries are in the house this morning. We are coming to you live from Choice Radio. Faith Life Ministries located at 844 Clarkson Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, where our whole desire is to build your faith and speak life into you. Stand by this morning. This man of God has a word from the Lord for you. In the next few minutes, I'll be bringing him on. And in the meantime, I just want to let you know that Jesus loves you. He cares for you. He wants to do all that you want him to do. He's calling upon you this morning, and he wants you to talk to him. He's at the right hand of God the Father. He's making intercession for you. He's calling upon the Father that you will be able to receive the blessings of Almighty God. I want to say to you, there's nothing too hard for God to do. There's no situation in your life that he cannot change. There's no sickness in your life that he cannot heal. There's no disease too big for God. There's no problem too big for God. We serve a God, a mighty God. The Bible says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. And because he is good, his mercy endures forever. The Bible, Psalmist said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. If he created all these things, if he made this earth, if he used his voice, his tone of voice to call things into being, to say, let there be and there was, and the heavens were created and the earth was created, the animals came forth, and you know, it's amazing, because after it all, he took time to make us. He formed and he fashioned and he molded us into what he wants us to be, into his own image and into his likeness. Tell me something. He created you. He made you. He formed you. He fashioned you. Do you think that there's something too hard for God to do? No financial situation, no sickness, no pain, no nothing that you're going through is too hard for God to overcome and change in your life.
The horizon, and I'm grateful because of your love. I can face any challenge that comes my way. Only in you I live, I move, and I have my being. I surrender my will to yours. Make me who I am in you. Oh,
Christ, I can do all things. Really doesn't matter if the enemy tries to harm me.
Of destiny,
but then I got it.
Stood naked in humility. Now I clearly see. Without you, there's no me. Oh, 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 oh.
Christ, I can do all things. Really doesn't matter if the enemy tries to harm me. There's no weapon formed will be able to prosper. I'll let my light so shine so everyone can see.
It's not about me.
About you, you, you.
It's not about Bishop.
I will pursue,
do what you tell me to.
It's not about 007. It's not about Mama.
Really doesn't matter at the end of me.
It's not about Papa. It's not about how much money you have.
Shine so everyone can see that me.
It's not about your nice house.
Yeah.
It's not about your sickness.
It's all about you.
It's all about you.
It's not about your pain.
About you.
Yes, it is.
It's all about you.
About you.
It's not about what you're going through.
It's all about you.
It's all about you.
It's all about Jesus.
It's all about you.
About you.
It's all about you.
Every day.
It's all about you.
About you.
About you.
About you.
About you.
About you.
It's about your worship.
It's all about you.
Hey, yeah.
It's about your praise.
All about you.
It's all about you.
It's about Jesus. No greater love hath any man. Right at this time, I want to bring on Bishop Vincent to bring you a word so that you can be encouraged that when you leave home this morning, you already have a word in your heart and a word in your spirit and a word in your mind that when you go to the house of the Lord this morning, that you will be already prepared, already ready to really go and worship and give God the praise. The word of God is life. The word of God is truth. There is nothing greater upon the face of this earth, no money. This, even though they said that money answereth all things, but if you don't have the word of God in you, believe you me, the money is going to be a waste of time, because at the end of the day, you're going to die and you're going to leave all that money and you still will go to hell because you did not obey the word of God. Bishop Vincent.
God bless you in Radio Land. It's an opportunity. It's an honor for me to come to you again with these few words coming to you from this radio station, 92.9 Choice Radio. An opportunity that we can grab and run with because of the word of God. I want to speak to you for a few brief moments, and I want you to go with me in the book of Genesis. I'm going to show you something in the book of Genesis. Chapter 2 and verses 7 says, and the Lord, amen, and the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into the nostril the breath of life, and man became a living soul. I want to ask you a simple question. What is man? The Bible tells us that man is composed of body, soul, and spirit. Listen, as the word of God comes to you today, let us just think for a while. Who am I? You are sitting down, whether you are a man or woman, a boy or a girl, and you are sitting down today and you're saying, who am I that Jesus should suffer, bled, and die for? The Bible tells us, as we look into the book of Genesis, chapter 2, as we continue to pay attention to what is being said, chapter 2, as we read verse 26 and 27, listen to what the Lord wants to say to you today. God is so real. As we continue to lift him up, looking, what is man? Man, we are thinking that you are so important. You are a choice to the plan of redemption, because God made you in his own image and likeness. God add to you certain personality similar to his. My God, that's an opportunity for us to think about, because I'm saying to myself that God made me, and in me there abided certain personality of the Creator, God the Father, because the Bible said, let us make man in our own image, the image of God. He created man, the image of God. He made man. He gave man. man that opportunity that man can live a life of peace. Man can live a life, a choice life, a chosen life. The Bible said, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all become new. What is your situation today? Are you sitting down and saying, who am I? Am I just dust? Yes, you came from dust. God formed you from the dust of the ground. He shaped something and breathed into the nostril of that. And then that becomes a living soul. That becomes man, body, soul, and spirit. So you have an opportunity there to worship God. You have an opportunity there to praise God and to know that I am not just a lump of clay. I'm not just here ordinary. I'm a very important person. Yes, you are very important because God made you. And God wants to say to you today, you got to worship me because I made you for that purpose. I made you not to go into the streets, into the world and do your own thing. I made you that I can communicate with you. I made you that we can have communication. We can talk to each other. Oh my God, it's an opportunity when you get up and take the word and begin to read and corner yourself and say, Lord, I'm coming to talk to you. Get ready, God, I need answers. I need you to speak to me, God, because you made me and you told me in your word that you made me in your image and likeness. What does that mean, really? The Bible tells us, God created man in his own image. God is a creature. God is so great that he looked down from his throne and saw the condition. And he said, I'm going down now. I'm going to send my son in the likeness of sinful flesh. I'm going to send him down to die. Because I made man, but man rebelled. Man stepped back from coming forward, from living for me. So I need a help to go down. The Bible said in John 3:16, our popular scripture verse, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Your life, your salvation.
So you were looking at yourself and saying, this is what the Lord has made. You ever get up in the morning and say, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad. This is the Lord's doing and it's marvelous. Because you are looking at yourself and saying, I'm a choice I've made by God. So I must serve God. Because if you don't understand the fullness of God, after God created us, the Bible says, man went doing his own thing. Because God made man with a free will. That free will that God gave unto man, the Bible says man began to go off in sin. Man began to take on his own plan. And the Bible says the soul that sinneth shall surely die. You don't have to die. You can come to God. You can repent. The Bible says, except and repent, we shall all likewise perish. That's why men are perishing, because they don't want to repent. That's why men are hesitating. If your son or your daughter do something wrong, you want to penalize him or her. You're not wrong. But after we penalize them, we have to turn back and love them. That's just like God. He made us. We fail him. And then he said, I will send my son to die for the sins that man has committed. Therefore, you can come to the Lord right now and say, Lord, forgive me, take me, accept me into your hand, because I am made in your image. What is man that thou art so mindful about? What is man out of clay, dirt? But God still loves us. We are choice. He didn't love the motor car. He didn't love the dogs. He didn't love the animals. He didn't love the iron, the stone, and the wood. God loves mankind. And he gave mankind an opportunity to serve him. Come and worship me, said the Lord. Whatever your condition, or the Bible said anyhow, man was made body, soul, and spirit. And for us to acknowledge the fact and see the plan of God, we must remember what is happening through the five senses that God gives to man. God make man, he give to us five senses to control that. And we understand God is concerned about us. We feed the natural man by food. That's the natural body is fed by food. The soul, which is the personality, is fed, glory to God, is fed by the word. And when we look at the condition, it is said that the soul is fed by the spirit. God made us in his own image. What are you doing today? What are you thinking of yourself? Men corner themselves. There are some young people, some people, and the whole, it becoming not only the young people, but everybody, men, women, boys, and girls, are taking a corner in their life, jogging themselves, committing themselves to the disgraceful attitude and alcohol, and giving themselves over to die. When we can just pull back and say, oh my God, that's not what you make me for. You made me to communicate with you. You made me to sing your praises. You made me to worship you. So the Bible said, he made man out of the dust. And when we think about who we are, oh, you are only thinking of the richness of a man, and you say the only time man is comfortable is when he has a lot of money. You don't have money, you can still be comfortable, but you must have Jesus. If you don't have Jesus in your life, it's like a disgrace. You are perishing, you are suffering, and you are saying there is no hope. I'm here to tell you, through this radio station, that you have hope. Don't give up. God has a way out for you. Whatever your condition are, whatever you are thinking about right now, God loves you. He cares for you. He made you son, daughter, man, father. Wherever you are right now, I can see somebody. I can see you just relaxing and questioning yourself. Who am I? Would God pay for my sins? Yes, he will. He did on the cross of Calvary. Would God accept me back now? Yes, he will. That's why we are here. He told me to go lift up my voice like a trumpet and show men and women their transgression. And I'm here to let you know that God loves you and he cares about you. Wherever you are, whoever you are right now, and you are thinking different "Oh, you don't understand what's taking place," you said, "Pastor, because I got no money to spend. My family gave me up. My family divorced me. They gave me up. They leave me to die." Hey, man, you got a friend. His name is Jesus. I'm talking about Mary's boy child. I'm talking about this Christmas time that is coming. A man was born into the world that you and I may have life and have it more abundantly. Would you take some time off right now and said, "Please pray for me. I need your prayer." If you ever made that decision, I want you to call this telephone number right now, 347-663-8638. Or you can call another number, 718-735-9687. And let us know that you make a decision. As a man, as a woman, I want to serve the Lord. I want to pray for you right now, wherever you are. Whoever you are right now, what I don't care what the condition is. And if I pray with you and you're blessed, meet me in church this Sunday morning at 844 Clarkson Avenue. We'll be there to meet you. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, this man, this woman, this boy, this girl that are listening to the program right now and they need help, they need Christ. Oh God, stretch your hands out and save to the uttermost. Heal that condition, that alcoholic condition, that drug condition, that cancer problem. God, in the name of Jesus, touch their lives right now and let them know that you love and care for them. What is man that you are so mindful about? Meet us. We're going to be willing to pray for you and with you and help you in whatever condition you have. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you as you continue this program, The Hour of Prayer. God bless you in Jesus' name.
But there's somebody out there. You are in a backslidden position. You have been not going to church as you ought to. You have not been going and worship God. Some of you are right. There are some of you out there that are saying, "I can do this in my house. I can watch the television and get the same blessing." The Bible says, "Do not forsake the assembling of yourselves together." What does that speak of? That speaks that you're supposed to go to the house of God and assemble with God's people. You never know who is there, who somebody that God is speaking to give you a word that will break through in your life. But you are in a backslidden position. We want to pray for you today. You are saying that "I don't need to go to church. I don't need to go in the house of God. I don't need to go in any church because my church is in my house." There's somebody there even today saying, "My church is in my house." Yeah, right. But we want to pray with you this morning and let you know that God can break through for you. God can turn your situation around. You are not saved. You have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You are in your house this morning. I want you to just lift your hands and you are in a backslidden position. Just open your heart and your mind and just let God speak to you this morning. Let God talk to your heart, because God wants to speak to your heart. God wants to speak through your mind. He wants to speak into your spirit. Father, that person that's out there, that individual that is out there in radio land and do not know Jesus, and the one that is backslidden, you are in a backslidden position, God is able to change your situation. Father, I pray for that individual this morning, God, that you will touch them from the very crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. And oh God, minister to that backslider this morning. Minister to that one that is in this backslidden position and renew their heart, their mind, their body, their soul, their spirit. Renew them, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that name which is above every name, because at that name every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Your spirit guide, and let your word abide.
Speak to my heart, Lord.
Oh my heart.
Give me your holy word. If I can hear from you,
if I can hear,
then I'll know what to do.
Then I know what to do.
I won't go alone.
So then I won't go alone.
I'll never go on my own.
No.
Let your spirit guide.
Paul the Apostle speaking to the church at Philippi,
In chapter 3 and verse 13, he says, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before." He says, "I press forward towards the mark of the high call, to the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus." I just want to encourage you this morning, saints, to press. If no other time in your life, if no other season, there is time for nothing else but to press towards the mark of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. We live in a day when we look around, it's just like the Bible says, there are wars and rumors of wars. Children shall be making children. Revelation is taking place. So I just want to encourage you this morning to press. To press. Press on. Press on. Because this is what God wants you to do.
Now it's time to ease your mind, so hear me as I say, life's not always down, you see. Hey. If the sun refused to shine and all your skies are gray, just sing this simple melody. Yeah.
I feel good, and I know it.
Come on. On the inside will show up on the outside.
Up, up, up.
Come on.
You know I'm gonna thank him.
The happiness in my life today, it won't be denied. There will be days we will feel down and blue, but that's not gonna be today. Hey, if you take the time to pray for me, I'll pray for you, and we can lift our voice and say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, I feel good, and I know it.
Come on. On the inside will show up on the outside. Come on. The happiness in my life today, it won't be denied. Sing it. Come on.
Don't hate me if I show it.
The joy I feel on the inside will show up on the outside. That's where they go.
I know I'm gonna thank him.
The happiness meant for my life today, it won't be denied. Said, I choose to feel loving, and peace is mine. Come on, a promise to me. Yes, yeah. That's how it's gonna be. It will be fine. Come on, there. My hand go up. Come on, say you don't mind. Have a good time, and I feel good. Yeah. Come on, somebody say it. Come on, you don't mind. Somebody praise him with me. You don't mind, cause he's real good.
Keep it locked. We will be right back with you.
Choice Radio. Your life. Your salvation. Your choice. Choice Radio.
Connect to Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone and look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
Coming to you from Faith Life Ministry. Join us this morning at 844 Clarkson Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, between East 51st and Utica Avenue. Services are at 11:30 a.m. We also have a Friday night service at 7:30 p.m. Our Bible studies on Wednesday night at 7:30 p.m. And we also have our Saturday morning prayer. And God is really moving by His power. He's moving by His Spirit. Listen, this is a prayer meeting. This is not inviting you to come to our church. We are praying for the nation. We are praying for the kingdom of God. We are praying for people. We are praying for the healing of the nation. We are praying. This is what it's all about. You are just coming to join us in prayer, and you can come there and lift your church up, lift your ministry up, and it is open prayer. This is what it's all about, prayer. Praying and speaking to God. So you are invited to come to our 5 o'clock morning prayer because God is about to do something. Come and pray with us. We also have an all-night prayer meeting the fourth Friday of every month. And you can join us there also. We pray from 10 p.m. until 4 a.m. in the morning. You are listening to Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. It's now 51 minutes on the other side of 7 o'clock. Our time is coming to a close for us this morning for this session. And, you know, it is so, time flies so fast when you are really enjoying the presence of the Lord. And you are in the presence of the Lord and God is doing great things. God is speaking to your heart and to your mind and your soul and your spirit. The man of God brought a word this morning. I hope you were blessed. We got about 8 more minutes, but after we have left this radio station, stay tuned because Victory in Praise is coming right up.
Please stay by me, Jesus. Stay by me, Lord. Please stay by me, Jesus. Stay by me, Lord. I know you hear me when I call. I won't give up in this fight of faith. Please stay by me, Jesus. Stay by me, Lord.
If nothing else I want to for the rest of my life is that Jesus stay by my side. This is why my endeavor is to stay faithful. My endeavor is to continue to lift up the name of Jesus and give Him the praise because
If Jesus leave me today or tomorrow, I don't know what I'll do. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know how I'm going to make it. I don't know how things going to happen in my life. And Bishop, if God leave us, if God forsake us today or tomorrow, it's all over. It's all over.
Without them, we have to continue pressing on. As you read the scripture, we got to press on. Paul said, I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. We cannot do without God. I don't know how some people backslide, turn away from God, and just would not serve Him, would not go to church. I want to advise you, get up, shake yourself, find yourself in the house of God, wherever you are. You have churches close to you. One person said the churches are more popular than the supermarket. You can find a church in every step you make in Brooklyn. Go to church. Let the Lord bless you. We cannot survive without God in this generation we are living in. Pastor, we got to seek the Lord and we got to pray some more.
You can imagine that there's so much chaos in the world today. You can imagine when God lifts His Holy Spirit from upon the face of this earth. Mm. What's going to happen? Holy Spirit, do not leave us nor forsake us. For this time we are here, Holy Spirit, stay with us. God, be on our side.
Amen.
And I love the Lord this morning with all my heart. And I just want to encourage you this morning to live holy, live righteous. I mean, it's not easy at times, but God says He is able to keep us from falling.
Listen what we got to say to you. Hey.
Lord, give me strength to face another day. Make it a long life road. Carry my heavy load. Give me strength, oh God, to carry on. Oh my Lord, give me strength to face another day. Make it a long life road. Carry my heavy load. Give me strength, oh God, to carry on. Oh my Lord.
Oh Jesus, my Redeemer, my Savior and my King, please hear me when I pray. Oh, it's for ages passing and hope for rest to come. Without you, where would I be? No, many are trying to live without God in their lives, but I wouldn't be so unwise. And so I promise to serve Thee with all my heart, and I beg in Thee mercy, my God. Lord, give me strength to face another day. Make it a long life's road. Carry my heavy load. Give me strength, oh God, to carry on. Oh my Lord. Lord, give me strength to face another day. Make it a long life road. Carry my heavy load. Give me strength, oh God, to carry on. Oh my Lord.
Life has become a burden. Still I am meekly waiting. Oh God, I'm waiting on Thee. I dare not make it alone. I need You as my own. Oh God, I call on Thee. Many are trying to live without God in their lives.
It's 57 minutes on the other side of 7 o'clock. We got about 3 more minutes, and I'm going to ask the bishop to have the last word and pray for the people out there before we leave this morning.
God bless you. We give God the praise for you and today. And we want to leave this and encourage you. This is Sunday morning. Get up, shake yourself, find yourself in a church where you can worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. If you don't have a place to worship, you don't have a place to go, we have a special speaker coming all the way from the island of Trinidad. He's going to be with us on this morning in 11:30 is our worship service. We want you to let the Lord have his way in your life as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, touch the lives of your people. This program, this radio, this ministry that reach out to the lives of men and women, we pray that you bless in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Take control. Bless. Bless this station. Bless the management. Lord, have your divine way. In Jesus' name, amen. God love you. Heaven smile upon you is the prayer of my heart for each and everyone listening right now.
Stay tuned. Victory in praise.
Stay tuned.
Victory in praise will be coming to you right after we have left this station. Don't go away. This woman of God will be in a few minutes to bless your heart.
All right.
Yeah, yeah.
So we getting ready to take it in.
Oh.
Here we go.
Said I owe you praise for the rest of my days. I'll be thanking you. I owe you praise for the rest of my days for the good that you do. To you I bend my knee and I bow my head and I lift my hand, 'cause you've been my rock and my foundation. On you I stand. When all around my soul gave way, you were my hope and stayed during those difficult days. When all around my soul gave way, you were my hope and stayed during those difficult days. Said I owe you all the praise for the rest of my days. I'll be thanking you. Said I owe you all the praise for the rest of my days for the good that you do. You make my life better, so glad we're together forever. And when it gets down to it, you brought me through it when I was about to lose.